Hi everybody and welcome to DevLab newsletter. And today I will show you a little bit behind the scene what's going on and what our development team is working on just right now. We are currently working on improving our architecture, and one of the important tasks is the implementation of a dashboard-centric approach. This means that we are building a new way of specifying a component which will be easy and convenient for any integrator to use and to create any dashboard. What exactly do we get as an output? At this stage of development, we can show you the new logic of creating dashboards. First, we define our data source and create a state that will correspond to the data source. Next, we can provide the state to any control and visualization to link it to each other and to the data source. Poof! And our flat grid shows the data. Thanks to custom tags, the grid itself is now set very simply through the markup. We can also set our elements, such as a toolbar. One line, and our control is already on the page. In this way, we can very easily create an entire dashboard quickly registering the tags of our elements. Since all our elements have the same state, they are connected to the same data source and show the same data. And they all have one toolbar. But the advantage of this approach is that the elements can be both connected and completely autonomous. For example, we want to give some grids a different slice to show, but from the same dataset. All we need to do is create another state with the same data source but a different slice defined. And then assign the state to the necessary elements. Voila! And we see the data from a completely different perspective. Let's add another toolbar to control the lower four grids separately. And don't forget to put the same state! As we added another toolbar to manage these tables, now we can interactively change the slice from the user interface. Though the first grid will remain intact. Thus, developers will be able to easily build a dashboard that will support the business logic of the required report, and the report will be convenient for the end users. In addition to a slice, you can even connect a different data source with completely different datasets in one report. As you can see, the field lists of each toolbar have fields only of their data source. On one dashboard with one component, you can have multiple controls and visualizations that will display different data sources and interact with each other in a way your end user needs. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and see you in the next newsletter.